I can't.
She don't even know she's an Indian. Wait a minute. You I really like calling them Indians, but that's the only way we can identify without becoming a woman Indian. Because Indian means they're
Indian means Hindu.
Mm-hmm. Indian also means savage.
Oh yeah. Yeah. Hindus are savage. That's that old bullshit. What's up, losers?
Douchebags.
He said, what's up, back? What the fuck is wrong with people, man?
Like, my friend reached me on the phone
about it. Oh, yeah, I'll go ahead and bring the scriptures out. You got anything you want to bring out? You can go first if you want. You got him eating on camera. I remember the last time you was eating. They had all kind of Edomites there, had jokes for you. They make a big deal out of anything. Ooh, I saw you eating. Exposed. That's how you do it right here. I forgot my fucking SD card again. I'm about retarded.
Deuteronomy 28 and 58. If thou wilt not observe to do all the words of this law that is written in this book, that thou mayest fear this glorious and fearful name.
Oh yeah, you gotta fear. You're supposed to fear the glorious and fearful name of Yahweh. That's the Most High's name. It's not God. Okay, it's Yahweh. Well, you see people call him Yahweh. In the ancient Hebrew, is spelled YHWH. Which is Yahweh. That means he to be. He is. Alright, read that again. That's a nice scripture. Hey, don't none of these fools out here fear the Lord. They a bunch of freaks and faggots. A bunch of adulteresses. A bunch of whores. A bunch of faggots. And a bunch of goddamn freaks. Look at all these weirdos. It's just weirdos out here. Weirdos and faggots. We done seen all kind of weird shit. We ain't been out here for like 10 minutes. Oh yeah, read that.
Deuteronomy 28 and 58. If thou wilt not observe to do all the words of this law that is written in this book, that thou mayest fear this glorious and fearful name, Yahweh thy God, then the Lord will make thy plagues wonderful and the plagues of thy seed, even great plagues, and of long continence and sore sickness and of long continence.
Yeah, so that's why everything's so disgusting out here. That's why we live in filth. We live in filth and disease. Everybody got diseases. Everybody got STDs. All these women got herpes and HPV. That's cause the reason we all got all these plagues and sicknesses. Bitches got AIDS. You know what I'm saying? It ain't safe to have sex. You might catch goddamn AIDS. That's because ain't nobody following the commandments of the Lord. All these women are sleeping with thousands of men. By the time a woman's 18, she doesn't have sex with 2,000 men. It's disgusting. And don't nobody want to go up inside of nothing like that after 2,000 men done gone up in it and did all kind of nasty stuff to it. Yeah, because nobody follows the commandments. And look at all these fat bitches. You know, there's so many fat bitches, it's disgusting. Half these women out here weigh over 300 pounds. They just eat pork all day, eating bacon, ham. And the Bible says you're not supposed to eat pork. But everybody's eating some goddamn pork. The number one food in America is pepperoni pizza. What you got? So these people are filth, man. These people are a disease. These are a disease, filthy people. You know what I'm saying? Everywhere you look is a disease and filth. Like you said earlier, what'd you call them? Viruses. They're fucking
parasites.
Parasites. That's right. They're parasites. You know, so all they do is they're a disease that just feeds. Just like they're worse than the flu. They're worse than these people are worse than AIDS. They are the AIDS of the earth. You know what I'm saying? A goddamn parasite of this. They have fucking tapeworm that's all up in your stomach, fucking you up. You know what I'm saying? Leeching off of you. taking all the life out of you.
That's not what, exaggerating.
That's what a hoe, one of these filthy hoes, they liken unto a damn tapeworm that gets up inside you and takes all your life force from you.
No, that's funny you said that. So there's a government study on divorce, and they're saying that women, when they leave their husband,
freak on camera.
When they leave their husband, their health deteriorates quicker.
They deserve it.
Than when they leave their husband, when they with their husband. But the husband, after the wicked ass wife leaves, his health improves. So that's true what you just said, man. They're succubus. They suck your life out of your ass, man. After you done do 8 fucking hours of work, man, you come home, you gotta deal with this thing.
We got goddamn Boy George fucking...
Right. We got us an arch enemy now.
There was 2 of them.
Yeah. Was it?
Yeah, there was 2 of them. They both had their faces painted white. Your mama sucks.
Your mama, bitch!
That was original comeback. Yo mama, bitch. Hey, you gotta be quick. Man, he said Jesus sucks. Man, Jesus will beat your ass. Well, hit you up. Hit you, huh?
Zeus.
You know what I mean. Yahweh Shah is gonna beat his ass. He right in his goddamn teeth with a mace.
Yeah, they motherfucker. Hopefully,
look, the bone store is shut down.
Yeah, it's good they got shut down. I'm so, what's that knock on track? The weed store.
That place too?
It's for lease. We done cursed. They kicked us out of there.
Oh, we could go back over there now.
Yeah, we can't go back. When we first started, we was teaching over there. Until they came out and they talked, you gotta leave. You can't teach the Bible over here. Fucking faggot. We used to teach way down there. What was we talking about before? That hillbilly
wicked bitches.
Faggot. Yeah, wicked ass. Yeah, that's what we always talk about.
That's what the spirit is.
Dude, I hate these hoes, man. These bitches ain't shit, man. These bitches ain't shit. I hate them. They're nasty, they're filthy. They're unruly, disrespectful. They have no morals. Man, what are you gonna do about it? All we can do is curse these hoes out through the spirit of the Lord, man.
That's all you can do.
But these bitches deserve to get their asses whooped. None of these women are staying with their husband. All the women are leaving their husband. Like he said, they came out with a study that said when a woman gets divorced, she becomes depressed. That goes against a natural order of the Most High. That's, a woman is never supposed to leave her man. That's why these women are a bunch of unloyal, filthy whores. A dog has more loyalty than one of these hoes. An animal. A motherfucking animal has more sense than one of these dumbass bitches. Retarded ass. And these women is retarded as hell. And bitches can't drive. Every time I'm driving every day, a bitch is almost hit you because she texting and driving. Listen to these bitches' cars. Because they ain't got a man, so they ain't got a car that runs good. All their cars is bumper hanging off, dents all up in their car.
Brake shoes gone, hear his metal scraping.
Yeah.
Serpentine belt squeaking.
Yeah, the back of the car just hanging. Got 10 kids up in that, with it, they're dirty as hell. One of the windows got plastic on it. You know what I'm saying?
Here you go. Ecclesiastes 26 and 22. And harlot shall be accounted as spittle.
As spittle. As motherfucking spit. So we spit on you hoes, man. We spit on you bitches. We fucking hate you. We wish death upon you. Okay, we hope you get hit by a coda bus. We hope you get fucking eaten by a wild pack of pit bulls.
It's coming.
You know what I'm saying? We pray with one of these crazy motherfuckers snatch your ass up, take you back in the alley, slit your throat, rape you, and dump you in a goddamn dumpster. You know what I'm saying? And that's what's gonna happen.
Spit nasty, man. How you feel with somebody spitting?
Especially if it's gonna be a loogie,
too. You still feel like,
That's just a rat. I'm talking about, we gonna spit on these hoes. There's that nasty green shit up in it, right up in your face. Yeah. No nasty one. Well, you dig down deep for it. That's how we feel about you women, man. Because you bitches ain't shit.
Yeah. A harlot shall be accounted as spittle, but a married woman is a tower against death to her husband.
Yeah, because that's rare. It's very rare to have a woman to stay with her husband their whole life. It just ain't gonna happen, okay? That's fantasy land. It doesn't exist. Even if it does exist, it ain't real. She done committed adultery on him 20 times, 30 times, 100 times. You know what I'm saying? Yeah. She's on the internet talking about, I got a man though, but he's on work right now. I need me a little extra. I ain't getting enough at home. Man, we see you bitches on the internet. Y'all be trying to get with us. Bitch, oh, I got a man, but he don't care. They be like, you know what I'm saying? And some dude, and a dude who gets with a woman like that, you know, this has got a man, the Lord's going to deal with you. You're going to get put to death.
Like the scripture says, that kind of fool lacketh understanding.
Lacketh understanding.
Proverbs.
And you deserve to get put to death.
Continue that form to get that problem.
You deserve to die a grievous death.
Ecclesiastes, I'm sorry. I'm going to get that problem. I hate a motherfucker like that more than a harlot, man.
Yeah, I hate, of course. He's worse than a bitch, because a bitch don't know no better.
Yeah, well, thank you.
Because a woman has the mind of a child, she don't know any better. Well, she knows better, but women are weak. They're the weaker vessel. You know what I'm saying? It's true in America, if you put an adulterer to death, they'll lock you up in prison too. When the Bible says you commit adultery, you're supposed to get put to death. But in this faggot-ass piece of shit country we live in, adultery is protected by the law. And the law and the cops are protecting adulterers.
Protecting
adultery. That's why all these cops, too, the Lord's going to put all these cops to death. Mm-hmm. Every last single cop deserves to be put to death. There's not a single good cop. They're a bunch of faggots and a bunch of bitches.
Don't exist. Proverbs 6:32. But whoso committeth adultery with a woman lacketh understanding.
Yeah, because if you commit adultery, you have no understanding. If you commit adultery, you just deserve to be put to death. And that's all there is to it. Back in the day, they'd just burn a bitch at the stake. They'd catch your ass on fire. You just got your hair did. Now it's in flames and you screaming. That'd be beautiful to hear a bitch screaming. Bitch's hair on fire, skin bubbling. You can hear her crackling. She's screaming. I'm sorry. No, you ain't.
I don't know where I saw the video at. He called his wife. He was beating the shit out of her, man.
You ain't see the video where the dude, she committed adultery. Then her husband came up, dumped gasoline all over the hoe. Then lit that bitch on fire. And she lives too. She ain't had no nose. Her nose was gone. Ears was gone.
And that's the price of adultery.
That's the price. Yeah. That's what happens when you commit adultery. That's beautiful, man. Yeah. We pray the more you hoes get doused in gasoline and caught on fire and get burned up and have your whole damn face melt.
That's crazy.
You know what I'm saying? Look.
And she probably heard the truth and after that committed adultery.
And then what happens to the man? They'll lock him up for that. He can go to jail for that.
Give him a death chamber.
Yeah, you'd be locked up for life. For doing something.
Righteous.
That's a righteous act. Because he didn't do nothing wrong. That's the woman that was in the transgression. That's why, man, this country, man, it's got to be destroyed. The Lord is going to destroy this place.
Yeah, Esau will get off, though, because he'll get off under that what they call a rage. A rage defense,
not
which
Jake.
Is actually real.
Well, Jake, yeah, if one of us did something like, if a Jake did that, he wouldn't even get a day in the court. The cops would just shoot him. Just like your boy that got shot down on Parsons. They killed his ass, didn't they?
I don't know if he died.
But they still
shot
his ass.
Though. They shot him up, though. And he didn't even shoot at the cops.
Fucking faggot shit.
Right.
The cops will shoot you if you just have a comb or a cell phone.
A toy gun,
it don't matter. A flashlight, a sandwich.
I remember one time your homie Jerry back in middle school pulled out a Sega Genesis game and they shot him in the hand.
Jerry, who is
the big fat black dude?
Okay. He gets shot over a Sega Genesis game. Oh, there's this one little boy that cop shot at because he had a Wiimote, a Wii controller. He was playing his video games. He got shot. And fuck these cops, man. These cops got a grievous punishment coming. The Lord got a special death for them. You know what I'm saying?
Ultimate Captain Saber, bro.
Yeah, they the ultimate Captain Saber, ho.
But whoso committeth adultery with a woman lacketh understanding. He that doeth it destroyeth his own soul.
Right, you destroy your own soul. So they don't know adulterer escaped the punishment. You think, oh, I'm, ain't nothing gonna happen to me. Okay, maybe not right now. A week from now, a month from now.
Right, right.
You know what I'm
Judgment's
saying?
Coming.
Yeah, you be at the beach swimming and a goddamn shark will bite your leg off in fresh water.
Right.
There's some freak shit will happen to you. Like, that was a freak. It was a 1 in 1 billion chance
Did
of that
Did you need
happening.
That? Fill out your book. Get stung in the heart by a stingray.
Right, right. You get stung in your heart by a stingray like your boy, what was his name?
The crocodile.
I bet he was doing some foul shit, bro. Yeah. He was living that good life, had that money. What was his name, the crocodile hunter?
I don't even know his name.
Irwin.
Steve Irwin.
Steve Irwin. That goddamn stingray got his ass.
What's up, bro?
Oh, what's up?
Oh, what up?
Hey, y'all.
What's up, brother?
They finally make it out.
You got a big-ass umbrella if you need it.
Weighs about 20 pounds.
I got another one in the book bag.
Oh, right there. Yeah, it's kind of consistent.
Yeah, it is. Yeah. I'm just so mad right now. I don't give a fuck. Look at that one. Oh, it's right here. That's that big dog right there. Talking about these nasty ass hoes.
that's new news every day.
Well, the spirit is on it, man, because it's been every day now. I've been hearing it, man, like the last couple of weeks, man. Telling the internet, all the camps, man, they just on these women. Even if niggas out there don't got the truth, man, but they know the Israelites, you know, them fake ass Israelite camps, they even on it, man.
Yeah.
They I thought they was in Queens.
Right. They wake up, they go fuck us, thank God for, thank the Most High for niggas like Polite, man, picking a black woman up. So them ISUPK don't just have it. They ain't got no choice but to come up against them now.
Exactly.
You know? Put them on the spotlight, you know?
Yeah, that goes to show that shit's bullshit. Mm-hmm. Because you had those Israelite fans that they was cutting them up. But they been going off.
Right.
But they was still cutting them up.
Going off like a mug.
They be going off. But they still was cutting up for life. As far as these goddamn women.
You see Polite shoot the Bible up yet?
He shot the Bible?
Yeah, with an Uzi.
Oh, man.
Bible
up
with an Uzi.
He's cutting up.
I'm surprised you ain't seen
that. He might get shot up with an Uzi.
Man, he ain't big, man. It's gonna be
That's something bad gonna happen to him.
We gonna see it. We gonna all witness it, man.
He's being straight up
bizarre. I feel sorry for that guy.
He's being
Actually, I don't feel sorry for him.
Right. He's praying for that. Something bad, man.
Yeah, man. Something bad gonna happen to him.
That's just a habit to say that.
Yeah. Man, you...
But
you've been an Israelite, though, so we do have pastors.
Well, it's not that, but he's like... When you see someone get fucked up so bad, you just like, damn!
Yeah.
Man, like, damn! Yeah, it's so disgusting. The death was so disgusting, you can't even look at it.
Right.
It was a heinous crime.
Yeah, something that bad. He might get his face peeled off. I mean, something bad could happen.
Thrown out the window.
Thrown out the window, get balled.
Him and his wife together at the same time.
He might get eaten by some Africans.
Mm-hmm.
Right. Something bad could happen.
Yep. But it ain't going to be pretty. Whatever going to happen to him, it ain't going to be pretty. He's crazy motherfucker again.
Oh, shit.
Here we go. This is coming to 33. A wound and dishonor shall he get, and his reproach shall not be wiped away. For jealousy is the rage of a man.
Right. That goes back to what we was talking about. Because if you commit adultery, that means you have no understanding. That means you're fucking retarded. That means you're evil as fuck.
Evil. Evil.
That's one of the most evil sins you could possibly commit, is having a commit adultery with another man's wife. And that's why you always go back to what O.J. Simpson did. What the spirit of jealousy came upon O.J. Simpson. And then O.J. Simpson, what did he do to that adulterer, Ronald Goldman, the Jew motherfucker?
Cut his ass up.
He sliced his ass, sliced and diced his ass. Mm-hmm. You know what I'm saying? Put them both to death. He did exactly as Leviticus commanded.
Yeah, exactly.
Their blood was upon them. He put the bitch to death.
He did it with accuracy, too.
Yeah, he would do it accurate. He sliced that bitch up in that piece of shit.
Wasn't they laid down next to each other?
Yep.
Or they wasn't that far apart from each other?
Yeah, they was right there. Same thing. Yep. That's great.
That's it.
Like that scene.
Yeah, what scripture is that? Where it was like, he won't accept no gifts, nothing. You can't give that man no gifts, anything.
Let me get that.
Yeah.
Don't finish this.
Yeah, numbers, man.
For jealousy is the rage of a man, therefore he will not spare in the day of death. I think it's number 5.
Sound like you're getting to it.
For jealousy is the rage of a man, therefore he will not spare in the day of vengeance. He will not regard any ransom.
Oh, that is it.
Oh, yeah, that is it. Yeah, that's spirit.
Neither will he rest content, though thou givest many gifts.
Oh, there you go.
That's great.
Yeah, you can't buy off the spirit of the Most High. That's why this country's so wicked. You remember that movie that came out back in the 90s? Because all these movies are about adultery. Right. So all these women and these men, they'll watch all these movies and they got adultery up in it. That makes them think it's okay. And then they listen to all this garbage ass music.
Mm-hmm. They glorify it.
Yeah, and the music glorifies adultery. People, all the rappers, that's all they rap about, is like, I fucked your bitch at.
Mr. Still Your Girl.
Mr. Still Your Girl.
Like, come on, that's ridiculous.
You know what I'm saying? That's nothing but filth, man.
That's why he took Tupac's wicked ass out.
And yeah, Tupac deserved to get put to death. That big, bald-headed faggot. People always talk about Pac as a prophet. Watching Dabu 7 videos, he was saying Tupac's still alive. Man, Tupac got put to death. He's dead. Okay? People are talking that shit. Hey, that's the same dumbasses who were saying Elvis was still alive. Motherfuckers is dumb, man. They believe anything.
Anything entertaining.
Yeah, but Tupac was no prophet. Tupac was not a man of God. He was a homosexual. He said he fucked all these bitches. Where's his kids at?
He wasn't even a brother.
They got videos on YouTube of Tupac having sex with blow-up dolls with Digital Underground.
Yeah, I seen that.
You
seen
that? That's nasty.
He had that in his documentary.
So that's a man of the lure, right? The guy that had sex with blow-up dolls, Tupac.
And it had nothing to do with the song that they were singing.
That's absolutely crazy, man.
He even got that song on Machiavelli talking about, was Jesus a con man or something? And the name of the song was Blasphemy. You heard that on Machiavelli, right? Blasphemy?
Yep.
Hey, yeah, a blasphemer. And then he had that other song, Hit Him Up, bragging that he fucked Biggie's wife. That nasty ass hoe.
Yeah.
And who the fuck would want to fuck something that Biggie was up inside of?
It was fake, man.
Right, that probably was fake.
Yeah.
I think it was fake.
Yeah.
That was all engineered.
That was publicity.
No, fake. That was her name.
Oh,
fake. Faith Evans.
That was her name.
I think it's fake.
Fake. Fake, bro.
Yeah, me too.
It might have been fake,
yeah,
though.
Yeah, it could have been. Publicity. That shit blew up.
Yeah, it did blow up. And he said he fucked it. Yeah, he probably didn't even fuck that hoe. You know, she had to be a nasty-ass bitch to be fucking Biggie. He even called himself the Black Nasty motherfucker.
Yeah.
And Biggie Smalls was a piece of shit, too.
He was a fight.
He got songs with bitches are shitting on him.
Yeah, that's
nasty. That's nasty, man. Y'all people look up to these fools.
All that bacteria.
Yeah,
in the song he put in there, this so far I suck your daddy.
Yeah, it said, bitch, that me and my bitch. Nasty, man.
What kind of bar is that?
Couldn't have came up with nothing better than that.
You know what I'm saying? Yeah.
It ain't giving no praise to the Most High. Hey, Tupac. Oh, fuck. Tupac thought he was He thought he was Jesus in the reincarnation. He got all kind of blasphemous shit in his music.
Talking about that Machiavelli shit, man.
I had him on the cross.
Don't even understand Machiavelli, man.
Yeah, Machiavelli was a devil. Right. That was Caesar Borgia's gay lover.
His partner, right, his yeah. Blue.
So, yeah, so when you say you name yourself after a well-known faggot, a homosexual, and a devil, Machiavelli wrote a book called The Prince, and The Prince taught you how to rule with an iron hand. It taught you how to be deceitful. It taught you how to oppress the poor. It taught you how to murder and to kill your way up to the top. And so Tupac named himself after one of the biggest devils to have ever lived. That's why Tupac is a faggot and a bitch.
Let me get this scripture. This is 2 Chronicles 30 and 8. Now be ye not stiff-necked as your fathers were.
Yeah, because our fathers were stiff-necked.
But yield yourselves unto the Lord and enter into his sanctuary which he has sanctified forever.
Yeah, this sanctuary, yeah, this is right. The sanctuary is the word. This word, the word of the Most High. But we in the sanctuary, that's the Holy Spirit. And we up in the sanctuary right now.
And serve the Lord your God, that the fierceness of his wrath may turn away from you.
Yeah, because the fierceness of the Most High is terrible. It's like, what happened to your boy Tupac? He got shot 5 times and bragged about it. Like, you know what I'm saying? That was a warning, you dumbass. I got shot 5 times, still alive.
Whatever the fuck.
Yeah, he mocked the Lord, yeah. He's making fun of the Lord.
Tempted him.
Keep going.
For if ye turn again unto the Lord, your brethren and your children shall find compassion before them that lead them captive, so that they shall come again into this land. For the Lord your God is gracious and merciful, and will not turn away his face from you if ye return unto him.
Right, that's what we're telling these fools. That's the whole reason we out here. You got anything you want to bring up?
Oh, I thought he was still reading.
Yeah, that was it on that.
Here you go. Jeremiah 5:26. For among my people are found wicked men.
Yeah, so that's talking about Israel. The Lord's people is Israel. The Lord came to save Israel from their sins. But the Lord said, among my people, among Israel, have I found wicked men.
They lay wait as he that setteth snares. They set a trap. They catch men.
Oh, that's really talking about a lot of these fake-ass Israelites out here. You got a lot of fake preachers, con men, robbing people, trying to control people. Like I said, they catch men. What did it say?
Yeah. For among my people are found wicked men. They lay wait as he that setteth snares. They set a trap. They catch men.
They set a trap and they catch your ass. Just like your boy, you got a lot of preachers like that on YouTube, especially like that dude Nathaniel.
I got one.
That dude Pastor Dow. He be tricking all kind of people. And Jake is easy to trick too, man. Because Jake is retarded. Oh, you had something else?
Yeah, this is where I want, actually. 5:20. Clear this in the house of Jacob and publish it in Judah, saying, hear now this, O foolish people.
Yeah, that's some fool. We talking to some foolish people. Our people is foolish. They're retarded. They're stupid.
And without understanding.
They got no understanding. They don't know nothing.
Right. Which have eyes and see not, which have ears and hear not. Understanding, pretty much.
They don't, what kind of knowledge they got? Only knowledge they got, the only knowledge these fools have is they got some Tupac lyrics memorized and some Lil Wayne lyrics memorized. They know the John Madden. They know how to play John Madden. They know how to play Call of Duty. What's that other shit they be playing now?
What is it?
Oh, they know all the codes, all the cheat codes for GTA. You know what I'm saying? They know how to get all the weapons. That's the extent of their knowledge. That, you know what I'm saying? That was their hidden mysteries. Their hidden mysteries is a cheat code for GTA.
They tell you the whole stats of the Fortnite championship.
Oh, they tell you every player on the team. They can tell you who got recruited. They can tell you who they looking at that's still in the 11th grade.
Yeah, the recruit.
Them know their high school stats.
Another mom and dad's first and last name.
That's some foolishness, man.
Yeah, that happened to me. I was buying my tire from Ford, man. The dude that came the way, he was telling me about the Le'Veon Bell, his Steelers running back, stats before he got to Pittsburgh.
He knew all
because he's from Columbus, man.
Oh, for real?
Yeah. Le'Veon, how you say his name?
Le'Veon Bell.
Le'Veon Bell.
Mm-hmm. What college you go to? I don't know.
I have no idea, man.
He's supposed to be from here. There's a couple of cats.
But two-thirds of them
I worked with.
He stayed out east.
Yeah.
He's from out east. He was telling me about the little league the motherfucker played in.
Same with that one motherfucker I just found out was from Columbus. That big eagle-looking motherfucker. Odin.
Odin?
Greg Odin.
Yeah. Greg Odin.
That was really a bad motherfucker right there, man. He was bad.
Oh, he played for Northland or something.
He was bad, man.
I remember him.
When he got to college, man, that motherfucker was dominating college. But injuries held him down, though. He had them fucked up knees. That's probably from eating all that junk food, candy and shit.
That two-thirds, that's all they knowledge of. Like, some of their hidden mysteries that they have is the Statue of Liberty. Or the flea flicker.
The flea flicker.
That's one of their dark secrets.
Yeah.
You know what I'm saying? Right. We know all the mysteries.
Reverses and shit.
Yeah. Laterals.
Oh, yeah. Trick plays.
That's good. That's
all the knowledge deep they got mystery. Right there.
Deep mysteries.
That's their mysteries.
Yeah.
And dark sayings.
Fucking wicked fools. Here we go. Hear now this, oh foolish people. And without understanding, which hath eyes and see not, which hath ears and hear not, fear ye not me, said the Lord. Will ye not tremble at my presence, which hath placed the sand for the bound of the sea?
These people, they didn't tremble at the presence of the Lord. It's like we just had a faggot drive by and said, fuck Jesus. Or some shit. He said something. People come by and laugh at you. Tell you that you're retarded. They'll say we're crazy.
Like these people say anything, they can get in my mind.
All right, you know, I'm just saying they don't fear the Lord at all.
We ain't out here under Jesus either.
They think it's a joke, right? No. But that's how stupid they are.
What he was even talking about,
right? Useless hair coming out of his
head. Yeah.
Shit. He built up that confidence and yelling.
You are in the car, right?
He's doing a drive-by scoffing.
I'll see him today. I'm going to say something this time.
It don't have nothing to do with what we're talking about.
Hey, dude, don't even talk to you. A lot of these people, they'll scoff before they even talk to us and meet us. You know what I'm saying? Yeah, they'll have no clue. They just know we're holding Bibles. That's all they know.
That's double for you.
Yeah, they got Bibles. They're no good. Oh, you should have seen your boy. Now, have you seen some clowns out here teaching? That's another story. On the way up here, we seen your boy down the street. He just had a Bible in his hand going, God loves you. Jesus loves you.
Close as hell. The Bible wasn't even open, was it?
No, it wasn't open.
They be having a seal on that shit.
You're right. That seal.
They probably like that guy, though.
Yeah, hell yeah.
We'll give him props.
Hell yeah. He's so green.
Yeah. That kills me, man. They just be holding it, not open, just like freestyling.
They read a scripture.
And read not one scripture.
Book full of precepts.
Like they'll even come out with John 3:16.
Yeah. These people funny, man. It's God a joke,
loves,
man.
That whole sermon is God loves you.
Yep, that's the whole thing.
Well, we telling you to...
One category.
We telling you the totally opposite. God hates most of you.
Jesus loves you.
The Lord don't love these fools, man.
But then, on top of that, you gotta... like, you know, try your best ability to follow these law, statutes, and commandments before you, you know what I mean, before you even get that love treatment.
But that's only for the elect.
Yeah, yeah.
Which is a very small percentage.
Yeah.
That is a minute percentage.
Personal righteous acts, bro.
The Lord is going to kill these fools, man.
That's right.
He's going to put most of these people to death. And there's only a very small percentage of people going to wake up to the truth. Very small percentage.
Oh, man, it's tiny, yeah.
Right, that's like finding a needle in a haystack.
Yeah.
That's how hard it is to find a righteous brother.
Here you go. Which hath placed the sand for the bound of the sea by a perpetual decree, that it cannot pass it. And though the waves thereof toss themselves, yet can they not prevail. Though they roar, yet can they not pass over it. But this people have a revolting and a rebellious heart. They are revolted and gone.
They're revolted, they're gone. They're totally gone. That's why when you see somebody, you look into their eyes, and you're like, oh, he's gone.
Yeah.
You're like, yeah, he's done. He's gone. I can just tell by looking in someone's eyes if they right or not. They just gone. I know there's no hope for them. You can just look in their eyes, all you see is just death and like a dark abyss.
That pit.
The eyes, man. That eyes is bad, man.
Yeah, the eyes is the window.
Everything. It tells us what the Israelite.
Yep.
A crazy ass retard.
A total reprobate.
Right. The mind dwindles to the soul. That's like bad, man.
I want to get a precept for you real quick. Psalms 101:1. I will sing of mercy and judgment unto thee, O Lord. I will sing. I will behave myself wisely in a perfect way. Oh, when wilt thou come unto me? I will walk within my house with a perfect heart.
That sounds like someone of the elect crying out.
Yeah, that's what we're supposed to be doing. This is my point, the point right here. I will set no wicked thing before mine eyes.
Just like the wicked in their all their hearts, that's all that's in their heart. That wicked thought. Before they go to bed thinking of a wicked thought. Yep. You know, same shit.
I will set no wicked thing before my eyes. I hate the work of them that turn aside.
Woo.
It shall not cleave to me.
Thank you.
A forward heart shall depart from me. I will not know a wicked person. Whoso privily slandereth his neighbor, him will I cut off. Him that hath a high look and a proud heart, I will not suffer. I'm going to just read the rest of this. Mine eye shall be upon the faithful of the land. That's what we're looking for, the faithful. There ain't that many of them. That they may dwell with me. He that walketh in a perfect way, he shall serve me. He that worketh deceit shall not dwell within my house. He that telleth lies shall not tarry in my sight.
Mm-hmm.
So we don't want to have nothing to do with these wicked fools, man. We ain't hanging out with two-thirds and being buddy-buddy with an adulterer and a piece of shit.
Bring them motherfuckers in your home to lay bed, you know, get rest and shit. Looking in your fridge, eating all your food. Nah, hell no. I don't allow that shit.
Talking all that bullshit, talking that rap shit all the time.
I literally don't invite nobody to my fridge, man. Unless it's your, you know, right. Don't know that automatically.
Motherfuckers are robbed from you.
Mm-hmm.
Now, I will early destroy all the wicked in the land, that I may cut off all wicked doers from the city of the Lord.
Mm-hmm.
Who's that? That was a Psalm of David. So David said he's going to put you fools to death. King David was a man after the Most High's own heart. He said he hates the wicked so much, he's gonna kill you and just put you to death and execute you, man.
You know?
Just chop your fucking head off. And that'd be the end of it. That's what happens in a righteous kingdom when there's law and order. When there's law and order in the land, an adulterer, he gets stoned to death, his head chopped off, he gets put to death. Same thing with the adulterers. A child molester does not get locked up in prison. A child molester gets put to death.
Get free meals and shit.
You get free, no, you get put to death.
Yeah, the rest of his life.
And it, yeah, there'll be no mercy for that. You get straight put to death.
It's a dumbass nation of people.
Then they get released and that they're a sex offender. They pass out later letters to the neighborhood. Beware, you got a child molester living next to you. Oh, thanks.
Like they doing some righteous act by warning you. This child molester around. And they motherfuckers should have been put to death. Thanks, Esau. Thank you. Appreciate it.
That's why there's no judgment and justice out here.
Devil.
You got all these judges and cops taking up for adultery. You got the judges putting men in jail for not paying child support.
They go to prison for that.
They go to prison for that.
Child support.
So, I mean, really those judges, according to the laws of the Bible, deserve to get put to death.
That's right.
David said he had have no wicked person before his presence. Mm. He had just straight slaughter you.
Neither say they in their heart, let us now fear the Lord our power, that giveth rain, both the former and the latter, in his season. He reserveth unto us the appointed weeks of the harvest. Your iniquities have turned away these things, and your sins have withholded good things from you. That was doing that.
We got something for you.
Isaiah 59:3. For your hands are defiled with blood, and your fingers with iniquity. Your lips have spoken lies, your tongue has murdered perverseness.
That's talking about our people. Israel is wicked as hell, man. Keep going.
None calleth for justice, nor any pleaded for the truth.
Right, there's nobody out here calling for justice. You don't see people out here protesting and complaining. You know what I'm saying? Ain't nobody out here complaining about these cops, complaining about these judges. Because all these cops do is get revenue. All they gonna pull you over. Take your money. That's all a cop. They don't care about stopping crime and locking people up. To actually, like, a cop will never arrest an adulterous woman for adultery. They'll actually protect that hoe. So all these cops do is beat the shit out of you, write tickets, take your money. That's why when you go to the courthouse, the first thing you see when you walk in is cash registers. They just cashing you fools out.
A whole line.
A whole big ass line of them. And they only do that to poor people. That's how they keep you in slavery. They take all your money. And then guess what happens if you can't afford to pay that traffic ticket? What happens if you can't?
Lock your ass up.
They'll put a warrant out for you, and then they gonna come and lock you up over a goddamn traffic ticket. Man, so these, you gonna tell me death and destruction is coming, man?
Hell, you already can't pay that, and they add late fees and all kind of other court costs.
Everybody you know got a warrant. Everybody in the hood be like, I can't stay here. I got warrants. I gotta go.
This is Psalms 10:2. The wicked in his pride doth persecute the poor.
They to persecute the poor. That's like I said, the cops, they only mess with poor people. Ain't no cops up in them rich neighborhoods pulling these devils over, giving them traffic tickets. The cops are all up in the hood. That's the only place they're at. And they're rolling deep. They're deep up in the hood. And they fucking with you. They're pulling you over. You know what I'm saying? They will give you a ticket for anything. Any excuse they can get to up there, because they got to make so many arrests. They got a quota they got to make. Their whole job is to make money for the city or the state or wherever. They serving. That's their sole purpose, is to generate revenue. That's it. And if you get in their way, they shoot you. And their purpose is to keep you in slavery, to make sure you stay down. So if you try to get up, they put you down. I'll go ahead. You can get more than that?
Yep.
Hold on, let me get the rest of this real quick.
Psalms 10:2. The wicked in his pride doth persecute the poor. Let them be taken. Psalms 10:2. The wicked in his pride doth persecute the poor. Let them be taken in the devices that they have imagined. For the wicked boasteth of his heart's desire, and blesses the covetous whom the Lord abhorreth.
It's the Lord abhors this whole system. America is built upon covetousness. However the fuck you say that word. covetousness. It's a capitalist society. Everything's based on money. You know, it's like everything's built on capitalism and corporatism, which is slavery for you. It means you get nothing. What they used to say on that Jerry Seinfeld, no soup for you. The soup Nazi. He a Jew motherfucker. Who is he? I hate this place, man. I pray the Lord rain fucking fire on this country, man. Yeah, he don't leave a single stone unturned. Everything just get fucking obliterated. Everything. There ain't gonna be a single trace of this piece of shit left, man.
I will say, the only thing that's gonna be left is like the creepy crawlers.
Yeah, and then you only got cops giving you tickets and shit. If that wasn't enough, you got the motherfucking IRS all up in your pocket every week. You going to work. You barely make enough money to survive anyways. And here comes the IRS all up in your pocket taking, what, 30, 40, 50% of your check? Before you even get it, they just take it.
You have to answer for it, too.
And then everything else got taxes, too. Gas got taxed. You know what I'm saying? You go to the store, everything you buy at the store is taxed.
They got fucking hidden Jew taxes.
Yeah, you got Jew taxes. Oh, you look it up. If you got a U, look on all your food products. Anybody got any food products on? There's a bunch of different logos on the food. The most popular one is a U with a circle around it. When you they got an actual website. It's called the Orthodox Union, I think. I can find a link. I'll put it in the video if I can with the annotation. But I actually went to their website, so it's real. It's actually owned by the Jews, the so-called Jews, Esau. There's actually a fucking Jew tax on the food. The so-called Jew, he's running all this shit, okay? He owns all the grocery stores. The so-called Jew owns the fucking government. He runs the government. Who do you think controls the IRS? Who do you think owns all the banks? Is a so-called Jew. They print all the money.
Rats.
Rats. They own Hollywood. They run Hollywood. They control the news. But they don't control the news like they used to. Because now we get our news off of YouTube. You know what I'm saying?
Yeah. They're trying to get the hold of that.
Yeah, they... Soon, don't take YouTube for granted. Soon, they might make you pay to get on there to upload videos. So they could cut this shit off at any moment. You see, they already got on YouTube, they already got a new service where you can pay YouTube so much money a month and you won't see ads. You see that?
Yeah.
They just rolled it out.
Yeah.
So I won't doubt it if soon, because you got so many people too taking up so much server space. Uploading all these bullshit videos of video game playing and cats and dog videos and rapping videos and booty shaking videos. That takes up a lot of space on them servers. Plus, these devils hate the truth. So don't think YouTube will last forever.
Right.
They might start charging you for it. Or they just shut this shit down.
Brothers, we taking that shit up.
Yeah, you better use it while, yeah, we taking up all your servers. They got hundreds of servers just for our videos. Cause our videos be long too, boy. All these Israelite videos be long as fuck.
Right, yeah. Maybe at least hours.
Hours, days. You know what I'm saying?
Literally hours,
2 hours.
That take us some space.
Hour and a half. Yeah.
Plus now we shooting in high def too.
That's a whole movie.
Yeah. I'll go ahead.
Isaiah 59 and 14. When judgment is turned away backward, and justice standeth afar off. For truth is stolen in the street, and
equity is the opposite of iniquity. Iniquity is wickedness, and equity is good.
Equity.
That means, you know, equal. That's where you get the word equal. You know, like a fair shake. You know, equal balance. Everything's fair.
That don't sound like America.
So it, like, inequity would mean like out of balance. It's not equal. It's fucked up. They say everybody's equal in America. That's a goddamn lie. You know that's a fucking lie. That's the greatest lie that was ever told. Everybody is equal. When they wrote that on a piece of paper, half the country is a fucking slavery.
I only glad to just fucking eat them.
The same piece of paper calls the Native American savages, don't
they? Oh yeah, I forgot about that.
Right.
Yeah, and the Declaration of Independence called the Native American savages. Merciless savages. They were merciless savages. Where are they at now? They're so savage, they should have been able to dominate, right? Read that again.
Hey, truth still is weak. The German is put away backwards. Justice then afar off. For truth is fallen in the street.
Equity.
Equities cannot enter. Yea, truth faileth, and he that departed from evil maketh himself a prey. For the Lord saw it, and it displeased him that there was no judgment.
Yeah, because you can't get ahead in business in America by being honest. You get eaten alive, man. All these big business owners, they dirty as hell. Let's take something that a simple motherfucker can understand, like GameStop. You ever go to the video game store GameStop?
Yeah.
Let's see you trade some games in there. See how much money they give you. You take a brand new $60 game in the GameStop, they gonna give you what, $5 for it?
$20.
What, they give you $20?
They're losing the value, so they say you're hoping it.
They don't give you shit. I seen this dumbass bit. Y'all never take my shit to GameStop. I go to the flea market and sell it myself. But man, I seen a bitch go up in there with a stack of games this goddamn big. She probably got maybe $50, if that. They won't even have store credit. They won't even give you cash most of the time. I mean, they're just ripping you off, man. And that's the only way that you get ahead in this country is by robbing and stealing. You know what I'm saying? That's what I said.
You gotta be cutthroat.
You gotta be cutthroat. That's the only way. That's how this country is built.
Comes
upon
lightning.
Thievery.
It's like, the American pie is the slice of the devil's pie.
Yeah. That's why, like John 10:10 says, the thief cometh not but to steal, kill, and destroy.
Right. Take the old, only no grapes, nothing.
Right. There's laws in the Bible in the Old Testament that say a farmer, when you plant your field, and say you plant corn and grapes or whatever, you got an orchid. After you harvest your crops, you're supposed to leave some fruits and vegetables on the crop for the poor people to come and take it for free. But what happens if you get caught taking apples off a tree that grew on the earth that God created? You get locked up. That charge you with trespassing and stealing. You know what I'm saying?
They charge you with like four or five different things.
All kind of accounts. Then you get a ticket. Then you can't, you already poor. Now you can't afford a ticket. So you don't pay. Now you got a warrant. Now you're going to jail.
I got a precept, bro. Obadiah 5. If thieves came to thee, if robbers by night, how art thou cut off? Would they not have stolen till they had enough? If the grape gatherers came to thee, would they not leave some grapes?
Oh, that's on time.
How are the things of Esau searched out? How are his hidden things sought up?
And that go right to Esau. That's what we're talking about specifically. Yeah. The Esau don't leave nothing.
He's coming to clean you out.
Clean you out.
Clean it out.
That's why you got the IRS. The IRS is there. They ain't just there just to take your money. They there to make sure that you stay down and that you don't ever come up. It's a system of slavery. Because the devils, they print the money. They don't need the money. You know what I'm saying? Why would the government, if the government prints the money, why would you have to give it back to them if they print it? It's all about it. They keep you in slavery. They keep you down. They don't want you to come up.
It's like they make a certain amount of money. They keep this bullshit flowing around. They print out a certain amount.
Yeah.
to keep that shit floating, you know what I'm saying?
And they just print the money out of thin air.
That's how their debt goes up from the national debt.
And who the hell is all that debt owed to?
Right, exactly.
To themselves?
Yeah, because we got to pay interest on that money they print.
Yep.
We got to pay the interest on the money they make. Because they the fools, these the fools that use the money, that enjoying the debts of the credit cards and shit.
And these dumbass bitches too, man. I remember one time, I got in an argument with my baby's mama, and I was like, taxes are bullshit. She's like, no, we need taxes. How else are we supposed to pay for this stuff? That tell you how stupid these people are. They actually believe that those lies. Those taxes, if the taxes actually went to services, how come these roads are so fucked up?
Everywhere you go.
Right, yeah. Why is the interior rated D?
Right.
D minus.
Right. Oh, roads is collapsing. Bridges collapsing. You got potholes size of a crater on the moon.
They don't give them a D plus. They gave them a D minus.
D minus. That's pretty much an E. They're like, that's bad.
Right.
A D minus. That's shit. You failed.
They need a plastic bag.
Oh yeah. D minus, you failed the test, buddy.
Yeah, you ain't lying, bro. You ain't lying. I saw the other day. Actually, this was yesterday when I was reading it out. They ain't trying to put no money in this infrastructure, man.
Nah, they ain't.
They even saying, they even know that, man. They're not even putting money into the military, really, no more.
They put money into those prisons.
No, hell.
Into those concentration camps.
They still building more in Ohio.
You know, notice the only thing I see them really doing construction on is these freeway routes.
That's just for the military.
Yep.
Why for that
martial
for
law, yep.
Yeah. Mm-hmm. They got to make room for those tanks to travel freely through the...
Yep.
Hey, because you can look it up in the history books. The first freeways were built in America. Who was that to order that? The master freeways was
Roosevelt.
I think it was It was either Truman or Eisenhower. It was Eisenhower.
Right.
And he said they needed a nice freeway system going all the way to the country, so they would be able to move the military equipment, the tanks.
Here you go, yeah.
That's the whole reason that giant interstate system was set up, was for the military. And the secondary use was commerce.
Because these main streets, like these avenues and boulevards, they ain't fucking with, those freeways.
Yeah, that's for them tanks and shit.
Because every motherfucking time I'm out going to a job somewhere, because we be going all over Columbus. We're doing construction on freeways all over the place.
Proverbs 21:7, the robbery of the wicked shall destroy them, because they refuse to do wickedly, they refuse to do judgment. 13. Whoso stoppeth his ears at the cry of the poor, he also shall cry himself.
That
shall not be heard. Flowers.
Read that again, my fault, I wasn't paying attention.
Whoso stoppeth his ears at the cry of the poor.
That's what?
That's a good scripture here. Go ahead.
The righteous man.
Seven. I don't know about no seven.
Seven is back there.
Back there?
Yeah, there's a bus stop behind this building.
Seven. I see seven.
Yeah, there's no seven that comes down High Street.
It's hot out here.
You probably had to get it transferred downtown to the seven.
No.
Seven candlesticks.
The company told me by the college.
Which way you headed though?
By student something.
Yeah, it's behind this building. Behind the Union building.
Proverbs 21.
She's asking for number seven.
The Whittier.
Oh, Whittier. Oh, sorry for her. Oh, I don't want to go nowhere. Is she going near Whittier? They gonna eat her alive.
Eat her alive.
She got a fat ass. She gonna last long over there.
Where's that at? Where's she going?
Whittier.
Ooh, that's worst the part of the city.
That's fucking hood. That's the
that's
real
where she hood. Going?
That's the real hood right there.
Well, it goes through German Village too.
Oh, yeah, she's getting all kinds
of yeah,
German.
She better. Boy, once you go past Parsons, woo-wee. Go ahead.
She looked like the bitch from the Goonies cleaning the house.
Oh, with the, yeah, the dude Mouse was talking to.
Proverbs 21 and 12. The righteous man wisely considers the house of the wicked. But God overthroweth the wicked for their wickedness. Whoso stoppeth his ears at the cry of the poor, he also shall cry himself.
That goes to Esau, the government, the police, the judges, all going all the way up to the top and all the way down to the bottom of this government. They all, they don't give a damn about you poor people, man. They oppress the poor. That's all they do. They keep going.
Oh my, oh my.
This should not be heard.
Yeah. That's all they do in America. Oppress the poor, rob the weak.
Here we go. Psalms 36 and 1. The transgression of the wicked says within my heart that there is no fear of God before his eyes. For he flattereth himself in his own eyes, until his iniquity be found to be hateful. The words of his mouth are iniquity and deceit.
Deceit.
He has left off to be wise and to do good. He devises mischief.
Yeah, he devises mischief.
Upon his bed, he setteth himself in a way that is not good. He abhorreth not evil.
Love evil. He loves wickedness.
Love it.
Thrive on something. That's it. That's his bloodline.
That's what get on richer and richer and richer.
That's what you call a leech. Sucking the blood out of people. All kind of names to this goddamn devil. It's all kind of names to him.
Damn parasite.
That's why you got that bitch. Hillary Clinton, she running for president again. You see that? And she actually...
You know what? Durham called that a couple years ago.
What?
That this nation might end up falling under a woman.
Oh, yeah.
Yeah, like, just like Egypt.
I remember we was talking about that
they
one time, just like Egypt.
They'd be stupid enough to vote for that bitch.
Yep.
It wasn't Cleopatra the last so-called ruler
of Egypt?
She looked like Cleopatra and in the reincarnation.
Yep, there you go. And after Cleopatra, that was it. So it'll be good for America.
But she was just giving a speech, though, talking about she cares about the poor. And she wants to help us. And she's against the 1%. And that bitch is the 1%.
Is that what I'm saying?
She is part of that.
And you got these dumbass fools out here talking about, oh, Hillary. Oh, Hill Dog. That's my girl. That's my girl, though. Dumbass bitches need to put to death for that shit.
These motherfuckers got me like, they done sat and ate dinner with them. That bike went a few beers with him and shit.
That bitch is freaking as can be.
Did a seance in the White House.
That bitch don't, yeah, she did a seance in the White House.
Witch.
She admitted to it. Says she summoned up the spirit of Eleanor Roosevelt. Oh, yeah, what does a witch and a warlock do? They summon up spirits, right? Just like when you go to court, you get a court summons. The judge summons your ass to court. I go back to the judge being here. He's fucking a wizard, a warlock, whatever you want to call him. He's a devil. He's a high priest of Satan. Because the whole court system is all based on witchcraft.
That robe that he's wearing too.
That black robe?
Yeah. That looked like some warlock.
Should Catholic priests wear the same shit?
Yeah,
same
yeah.
Shit. Same
all
shit.
Black with same a clean shit. Shaven face. You're not even allowed to have a beard in the Catholic Church.
That's ass backwards.
Well, yeah, where'd they get that at? You're allowed to rape little boys, though. They just had another scandal up in the Vatican. Another dude got caught. They caught this cardinal that was up in the Vatican. So he was high up in the power. They caught he was going to homosexual orgies.
That's why I shut things off.
No, he ain't gonna get kicked out of. He just gotta do some penance. may get relocated.
See, he might get a reward.
Oh yeah,
and a bonus.
And they might send him to the boys' club.
Yeah.
And now he's got to go oversee some little boys.
Yeah.
That's your punishment.
High school, all boy boarding school shit.
Yeah.
You know how they do.
That's why you got the boys' club was started by the Catholic Church. You know the boys' club?
Yeah.
You go play basketball.
Every time I went to the boys' club, you always see priests walking through there.
Yep, sure fuck did.
Yeah, it's Catholic.
Even when I was in camp back in the day, they had some Catholic fucking up in there.
Father Flattery. You know about Father Flattery?
You just walk through the middle of the street, man. Get that on
foot. Ain't that the dude that slammed somebody? I know you had crazy motherfuckers.
Yeah, he was that far.
Hey, he go all over the place out here.
Afraid of having a father.
He came back and got that Wild Irish Rose on the bench.
Yeah. I pray that could be his spirit of vengeance right there.
Yeah.
You know what I mean? The Lord got him out here to fuck somebody up.
He gonna quit one day.
Right, he got that Wild Irish Rose.
He already did last year.
Yep. He slammed. He must have slammed the shit out of him.
He pulled his dick out up there.
Look at him.
He got that. Don't get it on camera.
You see that? That's crazy.
And that's where all the Edomites be at too. You know what I'm saying?
Yeah, he's up there pissing on Esau.
That's cool though. I like that, man.
He's like, fuck your
all
shit.
All them harlots be up in there.
He's like, I piss on your building. He's like, fuck your building, bitch.
Yeah, that is true, man. Because we in them times, man. Most high gonna be releasing a lot of
spirits.
Yeah, exactly. Hell of the spirits, man.
Death is all you're hearing about every day on the news, man.
Yeah.
Look, this bitch got caught. Some bees went after this bitch, and her twins died.
Some killer bees.
She was getting away, but she fucked the twins.
Hey, my mom was
bees.
There was some crows up there back over Pittsburgh attacking Edomites and shit.
Damn.
Swooping down on them.
Right.
Crows?
Yeah.
Fucking crows.
Hey, that's a bird of death. A crow, that's Odin's bird, ain't it? The raven or a crow?
Wow.
Yeah, the raven.
The raven.
Yeah. Well, it's still that damn black bird.
Hey, look, he wasn't finished.
Yeah, he gonna flip one day, man. He gonna actually hurt some, kill somebody.
Today might be the day. He just got in some Wild Irish Rose and was sitting
there. Hey, I feel like going to a body's nigga about 4 or 5 bottles just to see what happens.
Yeah,
some
Wild Irish Rose.
Follow from a distance.
With the camera.
Like, kill Whitey.
That Wild Irish Rose ain't no joke, boy. That should have you.
That's a cheap man's wine, man. That's a poor man's wine.
That should have killed you.
Yeah.
That's why they call it Wild Irish.
Yeah, that's why they call it Wild Irish.
They make hooch in jails. Jails, prisons, and the hooch tastes just like Wild Irish.
Yeah, it probably tastes better.
Tastes just like it.
Hooch. Yeah, that's funny. It's called Wild Irish.
Like watching that Notre Dame game when they was playing the Kentucky, that little leprechaun running around going nuts.
Oh, wow. Yeah.
Y'all gonna make me go buy some Wild Irish movies.
I ain't drinking that shit.
You ain't gonna drink that?
Hell no. Last time I drank it, I almost died.
I'm gonna give one, man. I forgot what it tastes like.
I know what
rubbing
it tastes
alcohol.
Like. Yeah, rubbing alcohol. Just go get some fingernail polish remover. Drink that.
Fingernail polish remover, put some sugar in it.
Yeah. Put some Kool-Aid in it. Some cherry Kool-Aid. Hey, you got fools that actually drink that, bro.
I know.
You got these motherfuckers chug some Listerine, rubbing alcohol, they'd drink anything.
Stupid racial people.
Yes, Israel does that shit. Yeah, only Israel would do that. All they care about is getting fucked up, getting drunk, getting high.
I want to see this dude flip out on someone.
And that was crazy too when we was out here. I think that was that day when he slammed the shit out of whoever that was.
Yeah.
I think it was out
here.
He
slammed a bitch or?
It was a woman.
Hey, you want me to run over to the store and grab me some Wild Irish Rose?
No,
I want you, man. We can do it. He's going to be out here when we leave. I swear I want you, man.
Oh, he came over here and listened to the word for a minute, too.
Yeah.
So he really in the spirit now.
He's scored for them.
Yeah, he came
in. Hell no, yes. So he knew what he's saying is true.
Yeah.
But he's so far gone.
I like him better than you think.
Hey, you're right. I like him better too, you know? Crazy motherfucker. He about to fuck somebody else. It'd be like, you watch that video on YouTube where there's a one Jake on the corner with a baseball bat. He's like, this is my street. And he took the baseball bat and just started busting random people's windows out.
Wow.
You ain't see that?
No.
He's going nuts.
That's what I'm talking about, dog. Flipping out. People losing it, man. What's his name? Gerald Salente, the financial expert.
Oh, yeah.
Dude thinks he's Rocky. He just started throwing punches in the air.
Oh, yeah.
What's his name?
He's man's
power. I was listening to Salente last night. He was on Rich Radio last night. Yeah, I like
Salente.
Gerald Salente.
Yeah.
Songs.
Yeah,
I know he's retarded, but...
He
got more attention than these other fools. He ain't got no respect for the cops, the government, none of it.
Run.
Go ahead.
This is Psalms 19 and 7. The law of the Lord is perfect.
Yeah, so the Bible is perfect. And we say that proudly. So this Bible is perfect. There's not a single flaw.
Great. We say it with confidence.
It was confidence. Oh, well, what does confidence mean? Confidence means with faith.
That's right.
Combining.
I just want to be out here. You know?
Yeah, fidelis means faith.
Faith.
Com means with.
That's faith.
With faith. So the Bible is perfect. You people are not.
That's right.
Psalms 19 and 7. The law of the Lord is perfect, converting the soul. The testimony of the Lord is sure, making wise the simple. The statutes of the Lord are right, rejoicing the heart. The commandment of the Lord is pure.
So right, so when the commandment says put an adulterous woman to death, that's pure.
Yeah.
When it says to put a faggot to death, that's pure. It's not, what do they say? That's Bronze Age barbarism.
Right.
Or so they tell you something, you got Christians who would say you gotta evolve with the time.
Yeah, that's bullshit.
But the Bible's perfect. They don't say to evolve with the times. It says the law is perfect.
That's why they come out with the new King James Bible.
The new English Bible. Everything's the new this, the new that.
It's ever evolving.
Like the Bible it's always something new.
Mm-hmm.
When the Bible said there is nothing new, it has already been of old.
Right. Nothing new under the sun.
There's nothing new under the sun. So this word is eternal, it's not new. It might, you know, with the words we speak, it might sound new to you.
This is ancient. Ancient.
Is ancient wisdom.
Rejoice.
Now, hold on. It's eternal wisdom. It goes beyond ancient.
Way beyond.
Infinite. Eternal, infinite, celestial wisdom.
That's literal. Yeah, that's right. Literal. That's literal. Celestial, that's bad right there.
Rejoicing in the heart, the commandment of the Lord is pure, enlightening the eyes. The fear of the Lord is clean.
Yeah, the light's the eyes. That's why you see we're lively. We're not like in a dead spirit like all these fools.
Mm-hmm.
He said they walk around, you look in their eyes, there's no light. Nobody's home. You looking at, there's nobody's home. It's like knock, knock. Nobody's home. All the lights in the house are out. You know what I'm saying? The electric got shut off.
It's dark.
It's dark. There was no light up in it.
The fear of the Lord is clean, enduring forever. The judgment of the Lord are true and righteous altogether.
Right, so the judgments of the Lord is righteous. All right, the judgments of the courtroom is unrighteous. The judgment of America is unrighteous. Okay, America is the kingdom of Satan. The kingdom of the devil, the kingdom of faggots, the kingdom of adulterous whores, the kingdom of filth and sodomites and rats and roaches, the kingdom of STDs, robbery.
This is big ass.
I mean, we could go on.
This is a big country of waste, a dump waste.
Oh, yeah, like a wasteland.
Junkyard. Yeah, wasteland.
It's Gehenna. That's where you get Gehenna. the valley of the son of Hinnom.
Yeah, Hinnom. Yeah, this is.
Yeah, the land of filth and trash. And this is hell.
That is spiritual because it says, in Revelation, amongst us, they're walking dead.
Yep. Y'all walking dead. Yeah, this is hell. Y'all talking about when you die, you go to hell. This is hell.
This is Psalms 19 chapter.
So living in this piece of shit country, this is punishment for the wickedness we committed in our last life. You know what I mean? For the punishment of our forefathers. Mm-hmm. Now we being punished for that.
Hey, I had a dream this morning, man. We was all together in some parallel hell. You know what I mean? And I was crying in my dream, man. Like it was some real food. I hate that feeling,
that was
man.
A hell of a business.
I hate that feeling, man.
You probably seen a past life or something.
Yeah, you know? I mean, I know how it feels to be locked up behind bars, sitting down in the bench waiting to go see the judge and shit, man. It's that same fucking feeling I had in my dream.
Yeah,
man.
You gotta take a shit in front of everybody.
Oh, God.
Yeah, they'll give you a bologna sandwich. You know what I mean?
Sure.
You get some pork.
All types of pork. That's the jail baloney, so you know that's like the bottom of the barrel.
Last time I was in jail, even the guards said that the guards refused to eat the food.
Yeah, they even know.
They called it fear factor. People was eating the food, they was getting sick.
What's up, Esau?
That was crazy.
That was the devil. I can see the spirit of the devil all over that face.
And that's how Satan come at you too, clean and...
Yeah, with nice suit.
You know what I'm saying? Nice suit and shit.
Because he lives in the physical world.
Speaking politely as shit.
He's in his kingdom.
That's the Edomite's whole style.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, speak perfect, eloquent English.
Yeah.
You know what I'm saying? You speak perfectly. He's always clean.
If you don't understand what he's saying, he'll just break it down to you and everything.
Right.
They look at you like you was a fool.
Tell you a whole bunch of smooth ass lies.
Mm-hmm. I got a scripture for that too.
Amazing people. The people be following the trends and that shit.
Yeah.
They're so amazed by it, man. So fucking amazed by this devil's talk.
And they look at us like we're filth.
Right.
Here it is, they're the filth. And they look at us like we're the filth.
Yeah, we've been out here for all this time. Nobody out here listening, man.
That's why we curse these fools out, man. With no, you know what I'm saying? We ain't scared. We come out bold as lions.
They don't realize when they walk up and down the street. That shit right around the corner.
Yeah. I got
right around the corner.
I got a scripture though. It's in Matthew 11:25. At that time Yahweh Shai answered and said, I thank thee, O Father, Lord of heaven and earth, because thou hast hid these things from the wise and prudent, and has revealed them unto babes. So the Lord ain't dealing with these people. They got degrees, PhDs, speaking perfect English. You know what I'm saying? They got the nice suits. They got men are giving them praise. They giving them speeches.
There's that scripture in Romans. We got
bitch was texting and driving.
Deceive the minds of the simple.
Yeah, with their flattering tongues.
Yeah,
how's that
smooth,
go?
15, butter.
Romans 15 and 16, I think.
Yeah, 16. That's that wise and prudent. I go with them so-called scholars and teachers.
Oh, Isaiah 3.
They don't really. They don't know a goddamn thing. You know, they going straight to the pit, which is death. You know what I'm saying?
The bottomless pit.
Oh, let me finish this up. Even so, Father, for so it seemed good in thy sight. All things are delivered unto me and my Father, and no man knoweth the Son but the Father. Neither knoweth any man the Father save the Son. And he to whomsoever the Son will reveal him. So you got to come in the name of Yahweh Shai, the Lord ain't dealing with you. Say, come unto me, all ye that labor and are heavy laden, and I will give you rest.
They're laden, there's troubles.
Because this kingdom is, this is a kingdom of Satan. This is not our rest. The only place you're going to get rest is with these words. The word of the Most High.
They're laden, everybody's still in front of that oppression.
He said, take my yoke upon you and learn of me. For I am meek and lowly in heart, and ye shall find rest unto your souls. For my yoke is easy and my burden is light. You know what I'm saying? Because, yeah, we are lowly. We heavy laden with all this. We tormented by living out here in this filth. This is the only place to get rest and comfort is right here. I'll go home there.
1 Corinthians 1:26. But ye see your falling, brethren, now that not many wise men after the flesh, not many mighty, not many noble are called. But God hath chosen the foolish things of the world to confound the wise, and God hath chosen the weak things of the world to confound the things which are mighty, and base things of the world, and things which are despised have God chosen.
Yeah, that's why you don't see people like Greg Lloyd's ass out here on the streets.
Greg Eric Green.
Right. Big ass Eric Green or
Eric Green.
What's his name? Big dude that was in the New World
Mean
Order.
Joan Green.
The big tall one. Kevin Nash. That's why you don't see people like that out here.
Yeah,
man.
Kevin Nash.
Big tall motherfucker.
He think he
man.
A big badass.
He is a big boy.
Oh, he's a bad
dude.
He's
a big boy, man.
He's talking about
that's
wrestling
a big boy,
dude.
Man.
Yeah, big sexy.
Oh yeah. He used to be called Diesel.
Yeah, Diesel.
The jackknife. That's what his move was. That jackknife.
Right.
He's still in good shape.
Yeah,
they came out of WrestleMania. Their last WrestleMania.
Yeah, remember Big Daddy Cool Diesel.
Yeah, the NWO just came out of WrestleMania.
Wow. Real?
Yeah, because I was watching some WrestleMania. I'm going off. Man. Exposed.
He's going off,
Hawk. Yeah, Sting was out there, and they came out and rescued Sting. And
oh,
yeah. You do the Kevin Nash still look.
Big
everybody else looked broke down. He looks big.
That motherfucker was like 6'6", 6'7".
Right. And another thing, too, about Kevin Nash, too, I was watching an interview with him, and he was bragging about how he had like an IQ of 180 or something.
Yeah.
He talking about he's real intelligent.
Yeah.
He don't know a goddamn thing.
Right. Book smart.
Think he's book smart.
Yeah.
Now, if you so damn smart, how'd your ass get in that low budget Thor movie? Do you see that garbage?
I gotta see it.
Was horrible.
Was it really? Wasn't nothing in it.
Nah, but yeah, that dude, he ain't gonna ever be out here teaching his word.
Mm-mm.
He's already got his consolation.
Mm-hmm.
His
pride. They had he ain't gonna ever be out here neither, but he was on YouTube though, reading scripture.
Oh, your boy
Marty Stoudemire.
Huh?
Oh Marty Stoudemire.
You seen that?
Yeah. Right.
Marty Stoudemire?
Yeah.
The center for the Phoenix?
Yeah, well he used to play for Phoenix.
Oh, he still plays?
Yeah, he's still in there.
Well, he was being funny, or
he was being serious.
Oh, he was being serious.
He read
Deuteronomy. Oh, he was teaching about Israel.
He read the Deuteronomy 28:68 chapter.
Really?
Yeah, that's what blew my motherfucker.